But we have to get to the completely off the rails on that.
Let's get back onto the teacher. Yeah. We know that the teachers across the country today are protesting for higher wages in the classroom because they feel like what they do, they deserve more money.
So they do.
I could agree with that, absolutely. Colorado, 98 school districts within Colorado have decided to go to 4-day-a-week school week.
The teachers want, the teachers were behind that, right?
Well, it was a compromise. It was a compromise. They want more money. The school's saying we can't give you more money, so why don't we make it 4 days a week? You have one prep day, so you're still working that day. You're just prepping without, allegedly, you're prepping without the kids. So the question that we had this morning, Ariane.
How does this work for middle-class families that need to work on Monday and their kids no longer have school that day? So the school district came up with a solution. And they have child care services for those kids, well, for a percentage of those kids. So there are 18,000 students in that school district. For 1,200 students, there is a program where if you pay $30 a day per child, they will watch your kids. That's a very small percentage of that 18,000, I will say. But it's been working for 98 other school districts, so why not this one?
They've done this 98 times now. They've gone through this and to see what works, what doesn't work. I feel like this particular school district came up with this number to say, okay, only this amount of students need it because maybe others have a grandparent or a parent who stays at home or older brothers and sisters who can watch. But it would mean that they'd be off Monday, they'd go to school Tuesday through Friday and have a 3-day weekend every weekend.
Right, and that also means that their school days become longer by 40 minutes. So instead of extending the school year a couple months to make up for that amount of time, they're just making the days longer.
Sounds to me like those school districts in Colorado have a very strong teachers union. Because that's where this comes from.
Yep.
I know here, Sac City, with my son in elementary school, their Thursday is a shortened day. So it's, you know, they get out an hour earlier. And also with teacher, parent-teacher conferences, for a whole week, they have a shortened day. So I think that's all in response to teacher requests for more money, better health benefits, and then in the negotiation, maybe we can't give you as much money as you would like. However, how about we cut you all out earlier? And so it's all, this is all part of a big stew of compromise. I like that, a stew of compromise.
Oh, here you are again with
and
another
there
one.
There I am, yeah. It's necessity is the mother of stew of compromise.
Mm. So, what are they teaching in India this week?
What were you drinking in India? My question.
That's, Kingfisher beer, since you asked.
Oh. Kingfisher beer.
So Kingfisher, really So that's, I think it's all a negotiation.
I don't know. I feel like kids that don't have anything to do on those Mondays, they should be in school. They should be learning. Mm-hmm. Why are we giving them more time off? I'm a proponent of going to school all year round. Kids, don't kill me now. I'm here for it because I think that
happens a lot. When you, there's a lot of districts.
Yeah. When you compare us to international schools, and I lived abroad for a while, I did some study abroad programs, they are just more educated than we are in amount of time spent, languages learned, understanding of mathematic concepts. We need to do better as a country, and if we think that this is the way to go about doing that, I'm not sure that we're heading in the right direction.
Okay, that's a fair assessment. Fair assessment.
I can see that.
No.
I can see that. I can also see how 4 days a week, if you have 40 minutes a day that are a bit longer than your traditional day, and then you have 3 days during the weekend that are off to do that homework that you've been assigned, I don't see why that is a terrible idea.
It's like nurses who work 4-10s.
Yeah.
They work Monday through Friday. They work 10-hour shifts. Mm-hmm. You're already at work anyway. Why not just get it out of the way? And every week is a 3-day weekend.
One day less parents have to get the kids up to go to school. One day less you have to organize the caravan. What, I mean, yes, the issue comes when one viewer named Giselle said, I have 5 kids. So that's 5 times 30 times 4, because that's 4 times a month.
Right.
That's $600 a month. That's
extra.
Not in extra on top of whatever else she's paying for childcare or whatever else she's paying for anything else.
But that's
month.
Going that's going through the school's daycare.
$30. But
now,
but tell me, $30 a day from 6 to 6.
But
6
that's
to
per,
6
per child.
Per
right.
child. But
you
is
should
that bad?
Be able to find a high school kid that will come to your house that will babysit your kids like for far less than that. That's just the extreme to me.
But then you're inconveniencing other people.
Or giving them a job.
Or giving them a job. It depends. I mean, you need to, that to me sounds like the high-end cost of $30 every Friday times five kids times 4 weeks is just a lot of money. But there's got to be other alternatives to daycare than going that high in cost.
Which is why I think the school, for the 18,000 students there, they're only... They're saying, oh, we can provide this for $1,200 because I don't think that is a viable option for all people. Or they have all the different, they only need that certain amount of availability. And to me, it's like, I know it sounds like, wow, 18,000 students, there's only 1,200 slots for this daycare. Don't you think that they would increase that? I mean, it's more money in the school's pocket, or in the school district's
pocket. But they might not have the resources to provide childcare for more kids.
Or if you don't have that kind of money, your kids are basically home alone. And you have oldest of the five kids watching, and then that becomes a situation where, okay, that's a little risky.
Right.
And what are the kids doing all day long while you're at work? And, you know, that's the other option is no daycare.
So our editor, Tracy, chimed in on the conversation saying that she doesn't think it would be effective for education because kids already have a tough time retaining information. A three-day weekend would make it even more difficult for them to get back into the groove.
There's as many negatives as there are positives, maybe more negatives in this, I think, as a
parent
with
kids. I'm on team negative, and I'm usually positive Patty, and I'm negative Nancy today.
That's all right. That's
David Wong says he remembers reading this article because I posted it on my Facebook page. It got a ton of traction. So thank you, everyone who's here, who also had this conversation on my Facebook page. He said, this means that students would end school around 4:30. What's this going to do with traffic?
What 4:30?
If the school day is extended
40 minutes?
40 minutes. This is in Colorado, so maybe their day starts a bit later.
I don't know of any school that operates past 3 p.m. no matter what grade. So I'm thinking 3:40 is the latest you would ever. I mean, I'm not feeling that. I know my daughter in high school is out like at 3:10 or something like that. So I'm not thinking anything goes till 4:30 if you're tacking 40 minutes on.
Tracy chimed back in and said 30 minutes extra a day isn't enough time. It's 40 minutes a day. Is that even enough? 10 more minutes. It's a good point. And you, Tracy, go ahead and answer right now. You instruct students at the high school level, right, in terms of drum.
She's a drum teacher, but still, that's
teaching at that level. Right. And she would know more about those kids in terms of that age group and retention. I mean, you have high school age kids at your in your household.
As far as I know.
One, yeah.
Are they there right now? It is.
No, she's
at 40 extra minutes. At school, do you think that would help in any major way?
No, I think kids have a certain amount of window of attention span, and I think that they're ready to go when they leave, and sometimes they're ready to go sooner. I just think if you pile on them being there longer, it will also affect a lot of their after-school activities. Everybody's got soccer practice. Everybody's got swim practice. And if you push that back, that's a real inconvenience with doing homework later. So you can't back the truck up like that and not have the dominoes to fall. I like dominoes to fall.
Wow.
And, you know, I like that one too. Yeah, it's all in the stew.
You can't back the truck up unless you have the dominoes.
You guys should vote on which one was your favorite. Yeah.
What was my favorite BS comment of the day here?
David Wong says, necessity is the matter of invention. He is now quoting you.
It's the mother of invention.
I even misread that. Okay.
That's okay.
He said he did write Mother of Invention.
Okay, good.
Yeah, Walt has the lead for aphorism of the day.
Oh, look at that. The jazz, John Coltrane, whoever is back, signaling the end of this program.
I'm here for
that. Man,
it's Monday.
I feel like
it's Monday. Yes.
I like it.
Welcome back, sir.
Thank you. Good to see you.
Go to his page now for some pics.
Oh, boom.
From India.
All right.